Today, I'm super excited to be talking to Preeti Thomas. She's a manager of software engineering here at Red Hat. So can you describe more of what the container use cases are within the context of the operating system? Why are containers important to the Linux host?
It's really, for containerization, you can actually have your applications run on specific containers. You don't have to use your whole system to run an application. So okay. that's specifically whatever every container technology is so popular because of that, because you don't have to use the whole CPU running the particular application.
So basically, if you think about it from a large server mm-hmm. piece of hardware, mm-hmm. with the context of containers running within the operating system, I can have multiple applications kind of in a multi-tenant kind of way,
yes.
right? Taking advantage mm-hmm. of that same set of CPU.
Mm-hmm, exactly.
Okay, so greater density, is that one way to think of it?
Greater density.
Okay, can you tell me more about Podman and what the use cases are and what you would use that for?
Anything that you use Docker for, Podman replaces that, and there's no daemon. So it's a daemonless container application, and it's more secure. We can use it without root access. So that is pretty much the beauty of Podman.
I often think of root as God mode, right? They have uh-huh. the ability to take over everything within the operating system.
Yeah.
And that includes a server operating system where you might have hundreds, if not thousands, of users leveraging that server operating system.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so I see what you're saying there. Basically, I can build a container uh-huh. without having root access.
Yes, absolutely.
Okay. Uh-huh. What's the difference between Podman and Builda?
The Podman is really where you can deploy and run containers with, and use the CLI. It's really the command line interface. And then the Builder it's where you can use to build your images that Podman can use to run.
Okay, so if I'm doing like a Podman build on the command line, that would actually use Builder underneath the covers.
That's correct.
This is not a Red Hat only thing, right?
It's
definitely
that's
something
not.
We want yep. available to the world at large.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So giving them access to Podman and Builder would be fantastic.
Yeah, absolutely.
As it relates to the people that you manage on a daily basis, you know, you work with software engineers who are working on things like Podman and Builder, and these folks are obviously very close to the operating system mm-hmm. and very close to how you build and architect software that runs at that level. What would you say is unique about their personalities and their skill set? You know, what does it take to be that operating system type software engineer?
I think adaptability, meaning the technology is evolving, so everything, what people looked for in an operating system 20 years ago when I was starting was not what it is right now. So adaptability to and what is being aware of, what the industry wants, I think is
okay.
really important.
Well, Preeti, it was so nice to meet you today.
Thank you very much for taking the time to talk to me as well. I really enjoyed finally meet you in person.
I know, I've never met you in person before, so it's been a pleasure for me as well.